Espíritu y Espíritu Santo. Amén. En todo lo que va a dar. Yudica me dea sufficient mi caso me un de gente non son abobine in equo a todo su error en día. Antique por ti bien chico la dea Evite lucem tuum et veritatem tuum, ipse rei Deus servum, et in servum te montum sanctum tuum, et in tabernacula tua. Compite portit in cipela Deus, Deus meus quali tristis est anima mea, quali conturbas mea. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, introigo ad altari Dei, adjutorium nostrum in nomine Domini, dicere Dea omnipotente, beata Maria, Sancta Virgine, beata Michele, Arcangelo, beata Nomi Baptiste, Sanctis Apostolis Petro Paolo, omnibus Sanctis et Domis Fratres, quia peccavi in specificazione verba vocere, mea culpa, maxima culpa, ibio peccor, beata Maria, Sancta Virgine, beata Michele, Arcangelo, beata Nomi Baptiste, Santos Apostolos Petro de Paolo, Mune Santos, et Vos Fratres, orare pro me ad Dominum Deum nostrum. Amen. Desideratum vestri omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis vestris per vita vos ad vita mediana. Indulgentiam absolutionem et dimissionem peccatorum nostrorum tuo ad nobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Deus qui conversus vivificabis nos, os tendi nobis Domine misericordiam tuam. Domine exaudi orationem meam. Dominus vobiscum. Verbo mea alibus percipe, nomine intelligi clamorum meum, intende voci orationis meae, rex meus et Deus meus. Unio ad te orabo, Domine, mane exaudies voce mea. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Verbo mea alibus percipe, Domine, intelligi clamorum meum, intende voce orationis mei, rex meus et Deus meus. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Dominus tobis. Oremus. Presta quesumus omnipotens Deus, ut qui se affigendo carne ab alimentis abstinent, sectando justitiam a culpa deunet, per Domino nostro, Jesu Christo Filii tuo, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lectio Danielis Prophetae. In viebus illis, erat vir habitans in Babylone, et nomen eos Joachim, et accedi uxorem nomine Susanna, filiam Falciae, pulchrum minis, et dimensium Deo. Parentis eum filius, cum essent eiusti, erudierum filiam suam, secundum legem Moesi. Erat datam Joachim, dives valde, et erat eum pomarium, vicinum domui suae, et ad ipsum concluebant judei, eum quod esset honorabilior homini. Et constituti sunt de populo duo sine judices, in illo anno, de quibus locutus est Dominus, quia egresse est venitutas de Babylone a senioribus judicibus, qui videva ha dato Susanna et einem Bolabat in Pomario Virisu. Et videvant eam sede protivie. Ingredientem et eam Bolabatem et exarserunt in concupiscentia eis. Et eberterunt sensum suum et declinaverunt oculos suos. Et non viderunt celum, neque recordarentur judiciorum justorum. Vatum est altem cum observarem diem aptum, ingressa est alifando sicut erri, et nudius tertius cum duamus solis puellis. Volitque lavabi pomario. Estus cupe erat, et non erat in quisquam, praeter duo senes absconditos, et contemplantes eam. Dixit ergo puellis, affecte mihi oleum et stigmata et ostia pomarii claudite ur laver. Cum altem egresse esse puende, so exerum tuos senes, et atuerum aleam, et dixerum, ecce ostia pomarii causa sunt, et nemo vos vide, et nos in cupiscentia tui sumus. Quam potem astentire nobis et commiscere nobiscum, quod si noluerris dicemus contra te testimonium, quod tueri tecum nudenis, et ab quam causam e miseris puendas a te. Ingenuit Susanna et ai angustiae sunt mihi unique. Si enim hoc egero, mors mihi est. Si altem non egero, non effugia manus vestras. Sed nebius est mihi absque opere incipere in manus vestras. Quam peccare in conspectum Domini. Et exclamavi voce manda Susanna, exclamaverum tautam et senes adversus eam. Et cucurit plus ad ostia pomarii et aperum. Cum ergo avisent panorum pabili nomus et pomario, irerunt per posticum et viderent quintam esse. Postquam alter senes locutisunt erguerunt servi vehementer, quia nunquam vitus fuerat servo cuius ced modi de Susanna. De facta est dies graspina, cumque venisset populus ad Joachim gerum eius, venerunt in duo signoris plenii iniqua cogitatione adversa Susanna, puter ficere vera. Et dixerunt coram populo, vitite ad Susanna priam calcie uxorem Joachim, et stati dixerunt, et veni cum parentibus et vivimis et universis cognatis suis, blemam igitur sui et omnes qui noveram eam, consorgentes altem duo senores in medio populi, posuerunt manus sua super capo Deus, quae fletus suspexit ad celum, erat eni cor eius fiduciam habens in Domino. Et dixerunt signores, cum deambularemus in pomario soli, ingressa est he cum duabus puellis, et causa postia pomarii et inisi passe puellas. Venitque ad eam et adolescens qui erat ascorbitus, et concubuit cum ea. Coro nos, cum essemus in angulo pomarum, videntes nequitatem cucorimus ad eos, et vidimus eos pariter commiscere. Et illum quidem non vidimus comprehendere, quia portio nobis erat ad apertis hostis exilii. Tam altem cum apprehendesemus, interrogatimus, quis nam eset adolescens, et novi indicare nobis, cuius rei teste sumus. Regni eis multitudo quasi semibus, et judicibus populi, et condemnaverunt eam a mortem, exclamavi altem voce magna Susanna, et dixi, Deus aeterne, qui absconditor est conditor, qui nosti omnia acti quam fiat, tu scis comiam falsum testimonium tulerum contra me, et ecce morior, cum nihil orum fecerim, quae questi maliziose composuerum aversume, exaudi alter dominus vocineus, cumque luceretur ad mortem, suscitavi dominus spiritum sanctum pueri iniores, cuius nomen Daniel, et exclamavi vocemania, mundus ego summa sanguine unius, et conversus omnis populus ad ego dixi, quis est iste servo penturo cuius est, qui constaret in medio eon aia. Si patri, vidi Israel, non vidicantes, neque quod verum est conoscentes, condemnastis mira Israel, revertivi ad judicium, via falsum testimonium locutis non adversus ea. Reversus est ergo populus cum testinazione, et dixit ad eus Daniel, separate illos ad invicem populum, et iudicabo eus. Copergo divisi esse alter ab altero, vocavi tunum de eis, et dixit ad eum, in veterate vierum malorum, nunc venerum peccata tua, quae operabamis prius, judicam judice injusta, innocentes oprimens et temitens noxios vicente domino, innocentem et custum non interficies, nunc ergo si divisi eum, dic sunt qua opere liberis eus colloquentes sibi, qui ai subsino, dixit alter Daniel, recte mentitus est in capo tuum. Ecce in angelus Dei accepta sententia aveo, scinde te medi, et molto eo lusi venire alu, et dixit ei, semen Canaan, et non nulla, species decemite, et contubicentia subverti cor tuum, sic facievatis filiabus Israel, et filetimentes opimantur vobis, sed filia Iuda non sustituit iniquitatem vestram. Nunc ergo dic mihi, sub qua opore comprehendalis eos potentes sibi, qui ait sub primo, nisi autem Dei Gabriel, recte mentitus est et tu in capo tuum, manat in angelus dominum glabrium habens, quod secet te medium et interficiat vos, exclamavi dicaque, omnis cetus voce mania et benedixerum Deum, qui salvat sperantes in te, et con sorexerum aversus tuos senores, convicerat in eus Daniel ex ore suo falsum visisse testimonium. Dejarunque et inspicut mali egerum adversus proximum et interfecerum Deus, et salvatus est sanguis inoxius in die illa. Si angulem in medio opere mortis, non timebo mala, quorum homiam tenebum est, Domine, virga tua et baculus tuus ipsa me consolata sunt. Et remansit solus Jesus, et mulier in medio stans. Erigens autem se Jesus dixit eum et mulier, ubi sunt qui te accusabunt part, nemo te condemnavit, re dixit nemo Domine, dixit autem Jesus, nec ego te condemnabo, vade et iam amplius noli peccare. Today's Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Barbara Gismondi. Eternal rest granted to her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. May her soul and all souls of faith be pardoned. Our prayer for vocations, O God, we earnestly beseech thee to bless the Church and many priests, brothers, and sisters. Who will love thee with their whole strength, be faithful to their vocation, and gladly spend their entire lives to teach thy truths, serve thy church, and to make thee known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children. O Mary, Queen of the Clergy,
pray for us, pray for our priests, and pray for us,
the prayer to Our Lady of Perpetual Help. O Mother of Perpetual Help, grant that I may invoke thy powerful name, which is the safeguard of the living and the salvation of the dying. O pure Virgin Mary, let thy name be henceforth ever on my lips. Whenever I call upon thee by name, hasten to help me. When I speak thy sacred name or even think of thee, what consolation and confidence, what sweetness and emotion fill my soul. I thank God for having given thee so sweet, powerful, and lovely a name for my good. Let my love prompt me ever to greet thee as Mother of Perpetual Help. Maria Mater Ecclesiae et Domina Fatima. Please forgive me, I have my allergies that kicked in today. I apologize for that. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Amen. As I've said so many times, during Lent, the length of the readings is very long. And it's a blessing, because when would most of us sit and read this reading at home? How many of us read the Bible and learn from these stories? We don't. And so in the liturgy, they are proclaiming the praise of God who gave us this revelation, and they're also there for our instruction, for us to learn from them. Also, we have to prepare ahead of time, little ones. All of you, I welcome the FNE today, and also our first communicants. We're going to have the interviews today, so say a prayer for them. They're on the hot seat today. But we have to participate in the sacred liturgy by reading ahead and looking at these stories. As you get older, you have to read and prepare yourself so you know what's going on. Don't just sit there. You have to know what's happening. And I'd like to just go on today and say a few words about what was read today. First of all, this is a story in the book of Daniel about the woman Susanna. And Susanna was a very good person. It tells us that her parents raised her to live the law of Moses. She loved God and respected God. She married a man who was very rich. She was very beautiful. And in those days, not like today, and they lived out in Israel, which is very dry and hot in the summer. People didn't have bathrooms in their houses. They had sometimes rooms outside, or when no one was around, they would go out and take a bath in private outside, where it was cooler in the breeze, in the shade. And so her two servants took her out, got her ready, and they left. And there were these two old men who were judges, and they had bad desires in their heart. And they decided to frame her, to say that she wanted them to be with them, and they said if she didn't give in to what they were demanding of her, then they would lie and say that there was a young man here and that she had committed the sin of adultery, and they would condemn her. So the choice was either obey them and do evil against God, or obey God and be condemned by these two crooked judges. So she decided, after her long life of following God, that it was better to suffer under the hands of men than to suffer under the hands of God. And so she chose to follow God's law, to follow God's law, and not to give in to the demands of these wicked judges. And so when she said no to them, and she screamed for help, they ran out, and they called together the people, and now they were very upset. They were really mad. And usually this is what happens. When someone evil tries to tempt you to do something bad, and you don't go along with them, they get really upset because they want to drag you down with them. And when you don't, they then do what they can to destroy you or get rid of you or make life difficult for you. And so this is what these judges did. They decided to go against her and condemn her of adultery, even though she didn't do anything wrong. So they called together the people. Now, they were judges. They had a position. People respected them. And Susanna was just one woman among many who married a rich man. And so it says that without any proof, just by the accusation of these judges, the people believed the story. So it teaches us another thing about human nature, that oftentimes, without knowing all the facts, we believe the stories that are told. We should never make a judgment about someone unless we know all the facts. And if we don't know all the facts, we have to reserve judgment and not make a decision until that is known. And so when the Old Testament, the law of Moses, what is the punishment for adultery? It was being stoned to death. They would take her out and kill her because she broke a major commandment of God. So everyone in her family comes. They're all upset. They don't understand what's going on. And poor Susanna is beside herself, and she says a prayer to God, asking for God to help her. And so God does help her. God brings out this young man, Daniel, the prophet Daniel, and who is there, and he says, this can't be true. She's a good woman. She's an upright citizen of Israel, and these judges are corrupted by living in Babylon. So he decides to figure out what's going on. And what he does, he separates the two old men. And he says to one, where did this event take place? And the one said, under the mastic tree. And then on the other one, who didn't know what he said, he asked him where it was, and he said, under another type of tree. And so he knew they were lying because they weren't telling the same story. And so instead of Susanna being killed, the old men are condemned to death because they tried to unjustly kill someone who was innocent, and they are executed back in those days, which was the punishment. So there's a lot of things here. Susanna represents the righteous, the good, those who try to do what's right. She represents the fact that we're all sometimes in a struggle with sin, and it's better to stand with God than not offend men. It's always the right thing. It's always good and perfect to do the right thing, even if it's difficult for us, and we must never give in. But she's also a symbol of our Lord who would come, in that she was unjustly accused and she was vindicated. Our Lord was unjustly accused of being blaspheming, and he was crucified, and he was vindicated or had victory by rising from the dead. So that God's will always be done, no matter how much man tries to pervert it and change it. So with all that in mind, then we come to the gospel. And the gospel is about the woman caught in adultery. And again, what was the law in old Moses' law for those who were caught in adultery? They were to be stoned to death. And she should have been. She committed adultery. They were wanting to do the thing according to the Mosaic law, but our Lord is God. And he is above the Mosaic law, and he comes to bring us a new covenant, a new way of thinking, and he forgives her. And then he writes in the sand, and everybody goes away, and he says, woman, sin no more. So his condemnation was not to kill her, but to forgive her, and then command her to sin no more, to change her life. And this is what God gives us. When we sin, which we shouldn't do, we should try to avoid sin and live good lives. But if we do fail,
God will forgive us if we go to confession and we're truly sorry. And when he does, all those sins are washed away. We're restored to the beauty of our baptismal grace, which is a great, great, beautiful gift. So that the law of Moses, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, is gone now. And the new law is forgive each other as I have forgiven you. Let us, and we say that in the Our Father every time we say it. Now finally today, remember, all of these masses had a purpose in instructing those who were becoming baptized at Easter in the ancient world. But they're for us too. They remind us how much God loves us. They remind us that to follow God is the most important thing, to never live evil lives, that if we are falsely accused of something and we didn't do it, we have to stand up for what's right, and we have to pray to God to help us, and he will, and in the end, we will be vindicated. Maybe not on this earth all the time, but in heaven, God sees everything we've done, and when we die and are judged, he will reward us for being faithful to him no matter what we've done. So all of that is combined in today's beautiful Lenten Mass. And remember that we're getting very close to the Holy Week, to the remembrance of the Last Supper, Palm Sunday, the crucifixion and death, and the resurrection of our Lord. And so we should continue our Lenten practices in order to be close to him and grow holy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Gracius meus dirige secundum eloquium tuum, ut non dominator dei omnis injusticia domine. Thank you. corporale in lui ovizia compromis, mentre adebas, per tutta largirise premia, per Christo Domino nostrum, per quem maestatum tuam lavam angeli, adorant dominationes primum potestates, cigni cielo rumpe virtutes, a creata seraphim, socia exultatione concelebra, cum vivos et nostras voces, ut admite jubeas de precamor supplici confessione dicentes. Sanctus, 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 Domus Deus Salvo, veni sunt civi et terra gloria tua Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in Domine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. Sicur et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini, sit semper vobiscum. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi,
miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi,
miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi,
ora nobis pacem.
Domine nostrum Deus. Domine nostrum Deus. Domine nostrum Deus. Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tolli peccata mundi, Domine nos Dei, nos libertas peccum meus, se fatum de ferro et salami frami mea, Domine nos Dei, nos libertas peccum meus, Domine nos Dei, nos libertas peccum meus, se fatum de ferro et salami frami mea. Thank you. Dominus vobiscum.
And
quis omnibus omnipotens Deus, ut desert eos membra numeribor tuius corpore communicabis, et sanguine, qui te confitere regina in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, miliate capita vestra Deo. Praetende Domine fidelibus tuis dextra nec caelestis auxilii, ut te totum corde perfirmant, et quae vitae postulant, consequimeriantur, per omnium nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convivere regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti, Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Ite missa est. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Unitio Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem. In principio erat Verbo, et Verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat Verbum. Hoc erat in principio apud Deum, omnia per ipsum facta sunt, et sine ipso factum et libro corpo apparet. Et ipso vita erat, et vita erat lux hominum. Et lux in tenebri sucet, et tenebrae eo non comprehendere. Ut homo visus ad Deo, cui nomen erat Ioannem, sic veniti testimonio, testimonio per iberet de lumine, ut omnes credere per illum, non erat ille lux et ut testimonium per iberet de lumine. Erat lux vera per illuminat omnem hominem per etere mund nomen. Et mundo erat, et mundus per ipsum factus est, et mundus eo non coniovit. In propria veni et sui eum non regeverunt, quod potatum regeverunt eum, Dei eis potestatem filius Dei fieri, his qui credunt in nomine eius, qui non ex sanguinibus, neque ex voluntate carnis, neque ex voluntate viris et ex Deo natis, verbum parum patrum.